Well, hello there. Welcome to another episode of .NET MAUI 101. In this episode, I'm going to give you a ton of resources to kickstart your .NET MAUI learning journey. Welcome back to another episode of .NET MAUI 101. In this episode, we're going to see a ton of resources that will help you get started with .NET MAUI. Whether you're just starting out with your journey or maybe have a little bit of experience already, you want to go look for that specific feature and learn a little bit more about it. Maybe you just want to stay up to date with all the latest news. I've got you covered on all of those. So let's just hop into our browser and I will show you all the resources, and I'm probably still missing a ton, but more on that later as well. So hop into our browser and see what's there on the big bright internet. So this is probably the most obvious one. This is the landing page, the homepage for .NET MAUI. Now, you'll see the big URL here. You can also reach this website by going to .NET/MAUI. You'll go to the same page. If you see this sometime in the future, the design might have changed, but I'm sure all the useful information will be still there. Also, don't worry, you don't need to remember all the URLs. I will put them down in the show notes for you to find. So go check that out. If you see here, you already have a ton of links to other resources as well, which is really great. I'm trying to show you things that will, you know, get you started, and they will link to other resources left and right, and you can learn the exact way that fits you, right? You can read things, you can do interactive things, you can watch videos, all great stuff. So here you can already go to the Get Started, which will get you to an introduction, a more technical introduction. You read the docs, we'll get to that in a little bit. Go to the documentation page. There is some generic information here. Of course, there is a video by James Montemagno. Who else? Who can tell you about what is .NET MAUI exactly? And well, you can also go to the learning portal. We'll see that in a little bit as well. But one thing that I want to highlight here is the .NET Podcast app, which is an amazing solution. So I already clicked this link, and that brings you to a GitHub repository here, which is the .NET Podcast one. You can also go to .NETpodcasts.com, which is the hosted version. But this is the actual technical repository that has it all. And if we scroll down here a little bit, you can see the sample application. It has a full-blown backend, a web site, a web application, and a .NET MAUI application. That's what we are most interested in, right? The rest is nice, but we care about the .NET MAUI application. And it actually has two .NET MAUI applications. One where we use the actual .NET MAUI to translate it into however it should look like on the platforms. It translates all the abstracted stuff to how a button should look like on iOS and Android and Windows, so that you will know how to do it in .NET MAUI native, if you will. But it also has the exact same app, but now built with Blazor, so .NET MAUI Blazor or Blazor Hybrid. And it shares components with the web application and is really, really cool. This is a real-world application. There's nothing closer than a showcase that is being shown right here. It has a backend, microservices, ASP.NET, everything is included. So this is a full-blown reference that you can use to examine, to play with. You can host it on your own Azure subscription. I can't stop talking about this, basically. I'm so excited. This is really amazing stuff. So you can even see here the whole architecture diagram, container ready. Docker is in there. I don't know anything about Docker, but it seems to be cool. API management, Azure storage, SQL databases, and of course the MAUI stuff right here. So that is really, really cool. Definitely go check that out. So if we go further, then we have the documentation that I mentioned. So learn.microsoft.com/.NET/MAUI. This is your conceptual doc, so more like a descriptive text of how to do things, build your first app, set up your environment, how to hook up your iOS device, how to provision it, but also learn XAML, learn MVVM, learn about all the controls that are in the .NET MAUI toolbox. And this is updated continuously. New stuff is added continuously, so that is really great. People are hard at work and doing a great job with putting all the stuff in here that is useful for you. Following that, we also have the API docs. So this is the conceptual docs. It links, if you see a type, a label or whatnot, and you click on that, you go to the API docs, and that's more like the actual APIs that you will find in the .NET MAUI code. So, you know, you can see all the properties, all the methods, all the classes that are inside of .NET MAUI. That is the same stuff that you will see in your IntelliSense from within Visual Studio. So we have that reference for you as well. So if we go further, then we have this learn path, which is really cool as well. This is 6 hours of kind of like self-paced, but still you will have all the kind of like exercises, step-by-step things, descriptions of what you're actually doing and how you're going to do it, a little pop quiz here and there at the end. So that's always the thing that I fall for. You can get experience points that will be added to your account. You will get badges, you will get all the things. So this is a learn path, and that will set you up for learning .NET MAUI in no time. So if that's something that you like doing, definitely go here and check this out. Learn Live is a cool streaming thing that has been happening for 7 episodes throughout September to November 2022. So it's very up to date at this time. I think James Montemagno and a couple of other people did a great job. They have 7 episodes. Each time they were talking about a different thing. So create a .NET MAUI app, using XAML, customize your layout. So there's all kinds of things here that you want to check out. It was live streamed, so people had the ability to ask questions. So maybe your questions are in there. It was a really great thing to follow along, but now it's up there so that you can watch it whenever you want, basically. So definitely go check that out. Now, I already said that there would be a nice resource at the end where this was all be combined, and there is this great guy in the community. He's called Gerald, you might know him, and he's created this little repository on his account. So github.com/jeffersluis, that's me, /learn.netmaui, and on here I'm trying to combine all these resources that I've just shown you and much more into a single place where you can go and learn about all this stuff. So if we scroll down here a little bit, I try to capture it in a couple of categories. So we have blogs, books, code, social media, videos, and other. This might change a little bit in the future, I don't know. But more importantly, it's a repository, it's a GitHub repository, and you can contribute. So please do, because I'm out there, I'm trying to capture all of it, but I can't do all of this alone. There's probably a ton of stuff that I'm missing. Maybe you have a amazing YouTube channel or blog or whatever that I'm missing right here. So definitely add that here if you're missing something. I also have the official links in here, of course. And if you want to stay up to date with all the stuff, definitely check out this social media part right here, which is filled with GitHub repository, GitHub accounts from people that are active in the open source community for .NET MAUI, a bunch of Twitter accounts from people all over the world, Charlin, Leo Maris, I think they're somewhere in South America. James Montemagno, me, of course. But Alan Ritchie is a respected member of the community. And you can see much more people here. But there's always room for more. So make sure to add those. But this is a nice link, a nice place where you can find all the different links, all the different resources. And I hope it will grow by much more. Now, one thing that I still want to highlight is a not so obvious maybe resource, but it's the .NET MAUI repository, right? This is where all the code lives. .NET MAUI is open source. All the code lives here. And if you're looking like, hey, how do they actually surface this platform-specific code to the .NET MAUI layer? There's all kinds of examples in our actual code, right? We do all that stuff. We take that platform-specific code and we make it available on the abstract layer. There's all kinds of stuff that you want to do in your app, but we're doing that also inside of .NET MAUI. Now, it can be a little bit daunting. It's a big place. It's a big repository, but you don't have to tell anyone, right? So just open it. And if it's too scary, close it, try again the next week, right? You don't have to tell anyone, and do that a couple of times, click around, and you will find your way throughout this repository. And it has a ton of valuable stuff. So definitely go check that out, because you will learn lots, I promise you. And that was it for this episode of .NET MAUI 101. I hope you gathered a lot of new insights and resources that will help you on your .NET MAUI journey. Now, of course, there is a lot on my channel as well. So go check out this playlist right here with more .NET MAUI 101 videos with the fundamentals of .NET MAUI. Go check out this recommended video, especially for you, just for you, right there behind that computer. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel to find some more. See you for the next one.